Welcome to the DHS Program video series on tips and tricks to matching data to the DHS Final Report using your statistical software program. This video series covers the top 7 reasons why your results might not match the DHS Final Report. In this video, we will walk through reason 3, making sure you are using the correct variables. Question 3 is, are you using the correct variables? When browsing through a DHS dataset, you might see that we have numerous variables for one topic. It is important that you are finding the correct variable and that you understand the specifics of that variable. If you would like to know more about what is included in each variable, we strongly encourage users to check out the Recode manual, which provides a description of each variable in the data file and gives additional information that is not available in the data dictionary. For example, age variables in DHS datasets can be tricky because there are so many variables to choose from. Let's say we are interested in looking at the distribution of children's ages in the KR file. We know that the KR file contains information about children under the age of 5 years whose mothers were interviewed. When we search the dataset for age variables, we see one variable called B8, which is current age of child, while there is another variable, HW1, which is called child's age in months. At first glance, one would assume that these two variables should have information about the same number of children. However, using the data from the DHS model dataset as an example, we see that in the KR file, the variable B8 has a total number of observations of 5,335 children, while the number of observations in the variable HW1 is 2,507 children. Why might the variable HW1 have around 2,800 fewer children than variable B8 when they are, in theory, both examining the age of children in the dataset? Even though both of these variables have similar labels, they are not the same. The variable B8 in the kids recode file is the distribution of ages of all the living children in the dataset that we do not have missing data for, where the variable HW1 is a variable that corresponds to the ages of the kids that were eligible for anthropometric measurement as part of the biomarker questionnaire. The abbreviation HW is shorthand for height and weight, so the variable HW1 is corresponding to the ages of the children who were weighed and measured, which is not every child in this survey. Had you analyzed HW1 as the age distribution of children in the KR dataset, you would have seriously underestimated the number of children in the dataset. Another thing to check for is if the table you are interested in replicating includes survey-specific variables or contains new variables that might not work with code from previous surveys. Each survey is different, with questions or indicators that diverge from the standard. The DHS creates special variables to distinguish those that are not part of the standard questionnaires or indicators, but were only included in a particular country. These variables are known as survey-specific variables and usually begin with an S or a SH. Be sure to check the footnotes of the table or the survey questionnaire to see if the table you are trying to replicate contains a survey-specific variable. Additionally, if you are using code that was written for past surveys, but it isn't working with a newly released survey, be sure to check if there is a newer variable that you should be using instead. For example, surveys that were released after Zimbabwe DHS 2015 will now be including a new variable called B19 that calculates the age of the child in months using the day of birth and the interview date into account. All tables referring to the age of the child will be using B19 to select the cases to include and to classify the children into age groups. If you're using older code written for previous surveys and are not able to match a table, this could be the issue. Be sure to check the DHS program website for any new variables or changes in recoding. This video covered tip 3 for matching data and tables produced in a statistical software to the DHS final report. Please watch video 3 for even more tips and tricks for working with DHS data.